Hey guys, so today I'm doing my Bella Swan inspired look, and this is what I think she's gonna look like after she becomes a vampire. I didn't want to do like just Bella Swan because I think a lot of people have seen the movie and they already have that like picture in their head of what she looks like, so they're gonna be like, she doesn't really look like that, or she doesn't wear that kind of makeup or stuff like that. So this is just what I think she's gonna look like or have her makeup done as after she becomes a vampire. This is just my interpretation. Don't be mad when the movie comes out and it's not like this. It's just what I think. So I hope you guys like this. So you could use any kind of light brown you want. I am going to use this one and this one. Okay, so I'm gonna take the light one first and apply it to all of my eyelid. Just like that. And I'm gonna go above my eyelid just a little bit, like right here. It's really light so you can't tell. And this eyeshadow is really, really shimmery. So like the vampires, how they sparkle and everything, it's really shimmery. And now I'm gonna take this brown. Let me try it with this light. Can you see that better now? Right here. And I'm gonna put it in the outer corner like this. I'm gonna pat right here. And then I'm gonna go in my crease all the way, kinda like a windshield wiper. And I'm gonna come back up here and fix everything. And then I'm gonna pat towards the center, just like this. Okay. And you always want to like tap off the excess powder. Like I'm going to put a whole bunch on and then I'm going to tap it off and then do it. And I'm going to put a little bit under my eye as well. So it looks like that. But it's hard to do both eyes at different times because you kind of get like, they're not as easily, like, it's hard to get them to match perfect when you do them at different times. And next, I'm just going to take a black. You could use any kind of black. So I'm going to use just a little bit of that. And I'm going to tap it off. And I'm just going to put it in the crease, right towards the outside, just in here. Like that. And put a little bit more. Like that. Alright, and I'm also going to use a red. It's going to be this red. You can use any kind of red. It kind of looks orange, but it's red. So I'm going to get a bunch of that. Just because when I think of vampires and stuff, I think of red, just like most of you probably do. And I'm just going to go over where I put that black in the corner. And I'm going to go that just a little bit. All right. So now that part is done. I am going to take just a bigger brush. It doesn't have any eyeshadow on it. And I'm just going to kind of blend it together. Like that. Okay. And now you want to take a highlight color. You could use any highlight color you want. I'm using this color right here. It's really light. Hang on. Can you guys see that better like that? I don't know. Like this color. And I'm gonna put it on the big brush, tap off the extra, and put it up here. So you don't have to use, I used all drugstore stuff. You could use MAC, you could use whatever you want. You know, just use browns, black, and red. That's what you need. And next, I'm going to take this blue eyeliner by Stylish Style. The color is Twilight. It's a dark blue. It almost looks black. And I'm just going to put a tiny bit on my waterline. Okay, and now I'm going to use this Maybelline liquid eyeliner. It's waterproof too. I really like this stuff. It's just like this. And normally I like, with regular eyeliner, I pull my eye and I don't want to mess up my eyeshadow. So with this, you don't really have to. And I start in the middle and go towards the outside like that. And then I go from the inside corner to the middle. I'm just going to put a little bit, because I don't see, when I imagine Bella, I don't imagine her with a lot of makeup or anything like that. So you're going to wait for the eyeliner to dry, because it is wet, because it's liquid eyeliner. And then once it's dried, you're going to curl your eyelashes, and you're just going to hold that for about 10 seconds. Okay, and now I'm using CoverGirl Volume Exact Mascara. I'm just gonna put it on like that. And for my lips, I am going to use just this Squeeze and Shine lip gloss. This is like my new favorite, and it was like $2. You can use any kind of lip gloss you want. I would say get a nude color or just like clear almost, but just a little bit of pink in it, or beige. Like that. Okay, so that's my look. Let's see if you guys can see it better over here. Alright, so thanks for watching, guys. I got some requests to do a tour of my house. I don't know about that, but let me know what you guys think, because I don't want people to be like, oh, you're bragging or anything like that. Just let me know what you guys think. Yeah, so thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Bye.